In this translation, we will take some tabular CSV data representing points along a road, connect the points to create lines, join some attribute data to the lines from an access file, and write the roads out to an Esri shapefile. Let's take a closer look at our source data. Many users work with spatial data in a delimited text format of some form, such as a CSV file like we have here. This file contains GPS points representing surveyed roads. Each record holds a road ID value, vertex number, and XY coordinates for each point. The road ID is a unique identifier for each road. So these 12 records with road ID equals 1 represent one road. We also have some road attributes in an access file. Notice that there is also a road ID column in this table. We will use this key attribute to join these road attributes onto our lines during the translation. Let's get started by opening a blank workspace in FME Workbench. Go ahead and add a CSV reader to the canvas. Open the parameters of the CSV file to confirm that FME has picked up the schema correctly. We can also set the X field to be of type X coordinate and the Y field to be of type Y coordinate. By doing this, FME will create the points as it reads the data. Let's run with inspection to confirm. We are starting to see what our road network will look like, but clearly we still need to connect the points to create the road lines. Place a point connector on the canvas. If we just ran the workspace without setting any point connector parameters, we would get one messy looking line. We need to set the connection break attribute. Remember that the road ID is what uniquely represents each road. Set this as the connection break attribute. Let's run with inspection to confirm. Now that looks much better. Now let's read in the access file containing road attributes using the joiner transformer. Read in the access file and set the join on attributes to road ID. Add all of the fields from the access file. Let's add a shape writer. We will select automatic for the shapefile definition. Don't worry, we will see what this does shortly. Enter a name for the shapefile and set the geometry to shape polyline. As soon as we connect it up with the joiner, notice that the attributes are automatically populated based on what the destination feature type is connected to. Now, we really just want to see the attribute from the access file in our final output, so let's clean up the destination attributes. Open the destination feature type properties and, in the User Attributes tab, click on Manual for the attribute definition. This allows us to edit the schema. We will remove the attributes we don't need. Now let's run the workspace and inspect the output to confirm that our translation has worked.